to prepare for Atlantic Crossing was a bit different since it's set in another time and in another environment that I'm used to. I happen to live very close to the Swedish castle in Stockholm. So I went there to have some sessions with the people who works there, and they taught me how, you know, how to sit and how to move around the, you know, glasses, forks, knives, everything. I also read a lot and I studied pictures of her, and there's even some moving pictures, so I could see some small clips from her, the way she moved and the way she, you know, used her, how shy she was before cameras and so on. Every role I take on gets me to fantasize about a person in that kind of situation. And in this case, she's a refugee, even though she, you know, she's in contact with Roosevelt and he helps her, and she has food and clothes and everything. She is a refugee. She doesn't know whether she will ever see her family again. And that's not hard to imagine what that would be like. A human is a human, and what we need is security and warmth and food and peace. Dancing the night away.
You know, I always wondered why they're called the Secret Service. They're not secret. And the service? Not so good either.
Of course, I was starstruck the first couple of minutes, since I, you know, I was a teenager when I saw him in Twin Peaks. He's so lovely. He's a true gentleman. I think it wasn't hard for him to become this very charming gentleman that Roosevelt is in our series. We know that they had a very good chemistry, and we know that she was the person that he spent most of his private time with during the first years of the war. So they obviously liked each other's company. You know, you have to use your fantasy about what it would be like on the romantic level, but no one knows but them.
Hitler. Here's, he wants to make a move northward.
Norway.
Velkommen til Amerika, det vi søker.
I'm so glad you came.
Europe is on fire, Franklin. Help my country.